Hello everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Lakshya Gautam and today we are going to discuss about left shift and right shift registers and ring counter trainer kit and its order code is 38632. In this video, we are going to discuss about its application, components and principle of working. This is the left and right shift register and ring counter trainer kit. In this, you can see there are 4 flip-flops from 0 to 3. There is an inverter which changes the input according to the output. There is a pulsar or a clock switch. This is a 5 volt DC supply and this is a clear switch which is used for resetting the data stored in the flip-flops. So the first experiment is to study right shift register. So firstly we have to make the connections according to the lab manual given in the diagram. This is the right shift register. We have to make connection as same as given in this figure. So firstly we will provide 5 volt DC supply to J0 at flip flop 0 and other one to the inverter. Now the output of inverter is directly connected to K0 of flip flop 0. Now Q0, which is the output of flip-flop 0, is directly connected to the J1 and same as Q1 is connected to J2 and Q2 is connected to J3. Now Q0 is connected to K1, Q bar 1 is connected to K2, Q bar 2 is connected to K3. Now we have to connect all the clear switch. And lastly, we have to provide clock pulse to all the 4 flip flops. Now we have to ensure that all the toggle switches are at high position. And now we have to turn on the power supply button and then press clear button so that the data stored in the flip-flops are reset. When we apply clock pulse, the data from left to right side are shifted. So that's all in this first experiment. Now let's come to the second experiment. Now the second experiment is to study the left shift register. Again we have to make the connections according to the diagram given in the lab manual. So firstly we will provide the serial input data which is 5 volt DC supply to J3. And other one to the inverter. The output of inverter is connected to K3 and J0 is connected to Q1, J2 is connected to Q3, K0 is connected to Q bar 1, K1 is connected to Q bar 2 and K2 is connected to Q bar 3. Now we have to connect the clear switch. And lastly, we have to connect clock. and also J1 to Q2. Now again ensure that all the switches are at high position. Turn on the power supply, press the clear button and generate the clock pulse. As you can see, the data stored in flip-flop is at high position and shifted towards the left side. So this includes that the data stored in the left shift register is shifted towards the left side. The third experiment is to study ring counter. So we have to make connection according to the diagram given in the lab manual. Firstly, we will connect to J0 to Q3, Q0 to J1, Q1 to J2, Q2 to J3, K0 to Q3 bar, Q bar 0 to K1, Q1 bar to K2, Q2 bar to K3, and connect the clear switch. Now lastly, clock pulse. Ensure that all the switches are at high position. Turn on the power supply. Clear all the flip-flops by pressing clear button. Now put the switch at low position so that FF0 is set. Now again press at high position. Now give the pulsar switch. As you can see, it made a loop that the data stored in FF0 again comes to its same place. So that's all demonstration from my side. If you have any queries related to this trainer kit, you can visit Tesca Global website. The link is in the description. For further inquiries, you can go through the lab manual. Thanks for watching this video. If you like it, please like, share and subscribe to our channel.